It's been a while. It's been a while, actually. Feels weird, but it also feels really normal. So, Sketch Gamer, I'm back. And we're Frugal Retro Game Reviews. I'm a collector. I'm officially a collector. I always denied that. It was like a skeleton in the closet. But I'm a collector now. I buy whatever scraps I can get. Used stores, Kijiji, pawn shops, family, relatives. I'm gonna grab one of these games from my collection. Today, logistically speaking, we're gonna go with the Nintendo 64 because it's set up. A new kind of setup going here. I'm trying to set up a man cave in a very small apartment. It's very difficult, but it's a work in progress. We have some hockey figurines here. They're from the dollar store, so there's no real reason why I have these specific ones. Although, I do like this guy right here, Bryce Harper. That's a cool dude. I think once he called the media a bunch of punks or something, or Offspring. I love Crazy Taxi. They were on the soundtrack for that game. If you grew up in the 90s, you knew Offspring. They were part of your life. So the game we're going to select today is going to be based from the Book of Wisdom, which is 2,500 years. I almost forgot. 2,500 years of knowledge. Randomly picking one right here. The Best Answers Are Those That Destroy the Questions by Susan Sontag. Are Those That Destroy the Questions. So basically, like, you give an answer that's so explanatory, it explains itself so well, there's no denying it. It's like 100. And I'm supposed to pick a game based off of this quote. This is what makes this fun, is like you have no idea what you're gonna pick. I think I got one in my head. Yeah, I got one in my head. And I know exactly. So I'm still working on organizing this thing. Mission Impossible. Mission Impossible. I picked this up on Kijiji, and I remember I paid, this is high for me, by the way, $7.50 Canadian. First of all, what is Mission Impossible? I'm not an expert, but I believe it started as a TV show way back when. I want to say this, I don't know, 60s. I'll put the real fact later. Remade into, at least for, as far as I know, a movie with Tom Cruise. The Tom Cruise. I saw the first movie in the theater. It changed my life. I thought it was amazing. If you haven't seen Mission Impossible 1, I believe it came out in 96, this game is inspired on that movie, the first one. First of all, Tom Cruise is not in this game because he's way too expensive. You know how expensive it is to get Tom Cruise?
Show me the money!
Show me the money!
Like, Ocean can barely afford making video games. Forget about an appearance by Tom Cruise. But Tom and Mission Impossible are two separate entities. I want everybody to know that. Tom Cruise and Mission Impossible, two separate entities. However, yeah, it's like we all recognize McDonald's through Ronald McDonald, or at least we used to. Whatever happened to Ronald McDonald? Anyways, the quote was, "The best answers are the ones that destroy the questions." The funny thing is that I think this is the complete opposite of that. You're a secret agent. You're given objectives, very little information. This is a very secretive world. There's really not a lot of answers. There's zero answers. It inspired this pick. So let's get right into it. Mission Impossible. Let's just start this game up and then I'll tell you my childhood experience with it. You know, I wasn't very rich growing up. I was not well off. But, you know, my mom could afford to buy usually one game a year, but that was with me trading in a previous game. So I would collect the money from that. We'd do, you know, you did that. And I got this game after I saw the movie with Tom Cruise. So I loved, and I was waiting for this game. I believe it was delayed. Well, it looks exactly like Tom Cruise. Anyway, well, I mean, right?
It doesn't look like Tom Cruise.
I know, but you know it's Tom Cruise, right? You don't have to be told. It's close enough. And what I really like is the music. The theme song for Mission Impossible is famous. If you haven't seen the movie, you've heard the song.
Oh yeah, even I know this song.
Jim Phelps. He runs the show. Candace Parker, crack cryptologist. I should tell people that's my job. Jack Kiefer, the escape artist. This is the team, by the way. Andrew Dowie, electronics ace. And then, of course, Ethan Hunt, Tom Cruise, the point man. That looks like Tom, come on. Mission Impossible, boom. The mission, either possible or impossible. That's a great way to break it down. Like, you're like, okay, I wanna beat the game or I wanna struggle for the rest of my life. I'm gonna be honest with you. When I was a kid, I remember getting this game. I was super excited, but I had this internal struggle because honestly, it wasn't the greatest. I'll be the first to admit that. And you know, at 10 years old, like, you're like, we dropped money on this game. And I can't go around admitting that this game sucks. I can't do that. So when this music plays, 10-year-old John's gonna love it. But they're like, yeah, it's not as good as 007. I'm like, I knew that, right? I'm like, yeah, I know, but like, it's pretty good. So that's why I'm kind of interested to see how I feel about it again. Station, I remember that level. You're like a sniper. On the run now. I'm not part of IMF anymore, which is the security agency. I gotta prove my innocence by finding the real mole and capturing the information dealer, Max. We have a minute, what the hell is that? Clearly the train's rolling in. I know the graphics look horrible, but this was, I remember this being pretty damn good at the time. Everyone at their posts. Candace, do you copy? There's Ethan, there's Candace. They're waiting to intercept Max, and there's Luther, which is, I believe, me.
You don't expect me to reveal the mole's name without first checking the disc. Fair enough. Here's the disc. Do you have a copy? Thanks, dear boy. I actually feel I can trust you, but you shouldn't have trusted me. Men, dispose of the trusted servant. Nice knowing you. Goodbye, Tom Cruise.
All right, so now here I come in. Oh, goodness gracious. I gotta pull a couple shots here. Okay, one down. Oh no, what happened? Second one down. But I think they got Ethan. Okay. So, clearly this game is hard, man. That was impossible. That's it, but I'm gonna get Ethan's dead. Which, you know what? Big respect to all our secret agents out there. I mean, like, this is a tough job. I honestly would be the worst candidate for any type of Secret Service agency. I'm just a loudmouth, I rant too much. I can play characters though. Like, if they need someone to go in and play a character, I think I could do that. Yeah, I'm gonna do one more mission. Embassy function. When the airline seats were huge.
Good morning, Mr. Phelps. Former KGB Linex officer Alexander Golitsyn, now working black market intelligence under official cover, has abducted one of our top computer experts, IMF agent Candace Parker.
Oh, they got Candace. They got Candace. But look at the amount of objectives you gotta do. Like, here's your introduction to the game. Find the face maker, find the score, find the nausea powder, then just get the trank, place the smoke generators if you can, assume the ambassador's aid ID, and then access the restricted area. Come on, Ethan, this is a walk in the park. The coolest thing I remember about this game is that you could assume the identity. This later happened in, like, Hitman, if you ever played Hitman. But in this was one of the first games I remember you could assume someone's identity. I was supposed to poison someone's drink. This guy's got the drinks. I'm supposed to poison one of these drinks. How cool is this, man? Imagine being 10 years old and you're like, wow.
You feel like an adult.
Yeah, this is cool, man. Is this what adults do? Is this the club that everyone's talking about? And then, look, you can't go upstairs, right? Just like in real life as a kid, right? You're like, hey, man, I just want to go up here. It's like, bud, I'm going to get followed now. Watch. Oh, he's watching me, eh? Literally, something's going on back here. What are you guys, selling drugs? What's going on over here, boys? It's okay. I'll let you do your thing. I'll let you do your thing, Miroslav. Long story short, well, I remember there's something with this girl. She gotta give her the score or something. Watch out for Scottfield. She's extremely dangerous. So I just got a message. I don't know who that is, but that might be Scottfield. Anyways, but You know, it's funny, playing this again, I actually kind of have warm feelings towards it. I like it more than I think I did as a kid. Yeah, but you have to remember, I invested a lot. But back then, I paid $100.
What are you gonna do, Derek?
Show me the money!
And I knew what that felt like at 10 years old. Like, that was it. I had a make or break choice on a game, and this was it. It's not a game that I would invest a lot of time or hours into, but today, honestly, I'd give it a... I give it a 7. A 7. Now, like anything, I always have to look where this game is at in terms of price. Like, this is, in my eyes, this is a currency. This is... Game. Release date. 98. That just blew my mind. Because I really thought it was 97. Why is that interesting? I lived in a small town back in 98. I played that game in that small town for a very short amount of time, and in my mind, I was there for a longer time. It's weird, it just blew my mind. I'm gonna guess, it will definitely not be a million. It'll be somewhere in the 300,000, maybe? Considered a commercial success. 1.13 million copies have been sold as of February of 99 in the US markets. Wow. So I was one of the 1 million people that bought that game. I liked it. I mean, I'm gonna be honest, it wasn't my favorite game. I wanna know what people thought of the game. Just because a million people bought it does not mean they liked it. Wikipedia is a great source of information. But funny enough, it was frequently compared to GoldenEye 007. I had that conversation with the kids at school, and I had nothing. I had nothing, because I didn't have that game, and it was awesome. Blah, blah, blah. It was generally criticized for its inconsistent gameplay and slow controls. Amen to that. Next Generation explained Mission Impossible is not as polished as GoldenEye 007 because the game suffered from a difficult development cycle. I don't even know what that means. In France, reviews were more positive and highlighted the game's blend of action with subtle gameplay. I could be wrong, but I think Ocean might be a French company. Nintendo Power gave it a 7.2. N64 Magazine, 75%. IGN, 6.6. There's always one couple out of the bunch. Game Informer gave it an 8 out of 10. Who's paying their journalists, right? That's what I'm asking. So... we're gonna go to pricecharting.com because I think that's the best source. Mine's just the cartridge, right? If I had the box and all that, it would obviously be worth more. Here we are. Loose price is $7, but that is US. And there's apparently one sale per day. I just made $1.50, ladies and gentlemen. So that's the game of investing. You gotta see the game, know the game, invest in it. Sketch Gamer, thanks for watching.